Yep, it was a late night, but it was well worth it. Well worth it. Well, me and Sam Hahn were up here watching it for a while, doing our homework, and then we kind of gave up on the homework and went back to my place and watched it for a while, and then he went home in extras, and I ended up watching it from my bed because I ended up passing out real soon after that. My dad always has been a big fan. I kind of started following a little bit more like in 06, 07 when Alex ended up going there because I had a cousin play baseball here, Jake Opitz. He played second base for the Huskers, and so I always followed those guys, and once Alex kind of got drafted by the Royals, that's kind of when I started following him a little bit more. And obviously I had a really good buddy back in GI, Will Bombsberger, plays for Creighton now, and he's always been a big fan, and he's been a guy that's kind of always followed their farm system and just told me to keep believing that something special is going to happen, and it did, so it's pretty cool.
I know the season's obviously been disappointing so far. The fact that you've got an undefeated Michigan State coming in here, does that give you an extra bounce?
I mean, I think so. I mean, it's just going to be another big game in the Big Ten for us, another opportunity for us to go out and, fight and just keep battling, you know. Obviously, being a 3-6 football team, it's tough, obviously, but like I said, it's going to be a fun game, fun atmosphere, and I can't wait just to go out there and compete with the fellas.
You talk about you guys play Michigan State every year, and it seems like every one of these games has been a battle, no matter kind of what the records have been.
Yep, absolutely. Like I said, it's going to be a highly competitive game, two good teams, and like I said, you know, they're what, 8-0, 9-0, whatever they are, and they've got a lot to play for, and I think we just got to go out there with that same mentality that it's another opportunity for us to go out and win another game and, you know, try to put on a show and just try to, you know, finish this year out strong, and that's all we can really do at this point.
What's the key to not letting the negativity that's out there when it's a tough season seep into your locker room?
Absolutely. Like you said, you got to be able to X out the outside world, whatever's going on out there, and you just got to be able to buckle in and focus on what's going on within your locker room, because at the end of the day, that's all that matters. You know, we got guys in that locker room that are going to be making the plays on Saturdays, so we got to, you know, stay positive, you know, take this game as another opportunity, you know, to finish this year off and, you know, just try to make a positive out of this and just keep working hard and, you know, hopefully good things will happen.
How do you feel you kicked it
Saturday? I felt pretty good. You know, that first punt, I wish I got that first punt back, obviously, but they brought some pressure and kind of gave up on it a little bit, but the next two punts, I felt like I got them off pretty well, put them in a good position for my guys to go down and force fair catches or, you know, down those punts and, you know, just try to keep it out of a dangerous returner's hands, you know, and that's, you know, I ended up putting up some good numbers, so that was good.
Riker's ascension to the number two job in fall camp and now filling in for Tommy.
Mm-hmm.
With how long you've known him, I mean, does this surprise you how meteoric his rise has been?
No, not at all. I mean, me and Riker go way back to fourth grade whenever we met, you know, when I first moved to GI, and we've played sports growing up, baseball, basketball, football, you know, ever since we were fifth and sixth grade, so, you know, Riker just being the guy that he is, he's a highly competitive guy, and nothing really rattles Riker. So when the bright lights come on, the stage is the biggest. Hudson Riker's the best, you know. I think he went out there and he battled really well. I mean, for being thrown in the fire like he was, and you know, he battled like crazy. And I think he played a heck of a game. And I mean, obviously there's some numbers you can look at and criticize here and there, but I think for all given circumstances, he played a heck of a game, and I was proud of him.
Did you have to pick him up at all after the game?
What's that?
You
know, I just try to give him his own room, you know, let him do his own thing. But I walked up, said I was proud of him, you know, and throughout the game, I mean, whenever he came off the sidelines, always, you know, gave him a high five or whatever, just like, keep battling, buddy, you know, we got you. And, you know, he kept putting us in a position here in the fourth quarter. You know, he put us in a position to come back and win that game. So, like I said, I was just real proud of him, and I'm proud of the way he fought.
How much has he battled through, though, when you go back to May to now for him to get to this point?
Exactly. Like you said, you know, he had some issues that he had to work through, and he did a tremendous job of getting through that. And like you said, he had a strong fall camp, and, you know, he's just ready for his number to be called. And when his number got called, he stepped up, and, you know, I was really proud of him. And like you said, that's just the type of kid he is. You know, he's a competitor, and he doesn't really let a lot of things get him down. So I was proud of him, and he did a good job for us.
Do you have a sense of what the reaction's been like back in GI, having two guys that are having key roles on this team?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, I hope they're proud of us. You know, like you said, we're representing them, and, you know, they kind of gave us this first platform to jump on, you know, and so I was – you know, there's been a lot of feedback, you know, mom and dad text me and telling, you know, how proud everyone is of us and all that and stuff. So, you know, it's been fun. It's been a fun journey so far, and can't wait to continue it.
Anything else for Sam? Yes.
Appreciate it, guys.
Thank you.